My culinary quest across America has brought me to Sleepy Hollow, New York, a legendary town with legend-worthy eats. I'm at J.P. Doyle's in the heart of Sleepy Hollow, New York. This neighborhood favorite serves up classic pub foods, ales, and spooky tales. It's time to meet the Headless Horseman Burger.
A beast by the name of the Headless Horseman.
So, the Headless Horseman Burger.
Yes.
Have you ever had it before?
Yes. Oh, it's delicious. One of the best burgers in New York State.
One of the best burgers in New York State, the whole state.
It's hard to argue with this beautiful combination of bacon, cheese, and a mound of chili piled atop a 10-ounce patty of perfectly cooked beef. So good, it's scary.
Hey, Nick, how are you? Yeah.
Casey, welcome to J.P. Doyle's.
Yeah, thanks for having me back here. So where do we start?
We're gonna make some chili to go with the Headless Horseman Burger.
Chili to go, yeah. All right.
The chili starts off with onions, red peppers, and a slew of spices, giving the chili a fiery foundation.
We like to give the burger a little kick.
A little kick?
Yeah.
So you can kick off the head of anybody that eats it.
The Headless Horseman Burger.
The Headless Horseman Burger.
Next up, dark chili powder.
Ooh, right here. Is dark. That looks like a lava.
Dark chili powder is roasted longer than standard chili powder, giving it a rich, smoky flavor, which Nick tempers with their classic tomato sauce.
Wow.
Look at that color.
And then, bring on the beef.
We're gonna add dark kidney beans.
Okay.
And some already rendered down ground beef.
With the meat and beans in, Nick slow cooks the chili for 2 hours, then starts grilling their 10-ounce burger.
Right into the salamander, look at that. The salamander has a grill on top, so you can see the fire blazing on top of that burger. So when you pull it out, it'll be nice and crunchy on the outside and all the juices on the inside.
A few minutes in the oven, a layer of cheddar, and we start to build this beast. We start with a buttery brioche bun coated in JP's chipotle mayo, topped with Jersey tomatoes, lettuce, onions, that juicy beef patty with melted Irish cheddar, 3 strips of crispy bacon, and a heaping ladle of their slow-cooked chili.
There we go.
There it is. So we got chili, we got fries, with a 10-ounce burger sizzling right in the middle there. I give you the Headless Horseman Burger. Unbelievable. I'm ready to take it down.
Oh my God.
Gotta make sure I get the bacon and the chili and the pickles and the tomato and the iceberg lettuce.
How was that?
The chili just punches you in the face. I mean, it was smoky, it was spicy, it was crunchy with the iceberg lettuce. There's so much going on, it kind of knocked my head off. Headless Horseman knocked my head off. Can I take another bite?
Just outside Sleepy Hollow, New York at the Oath, a craft beer sanctuary dishing up crazy new spins on classic comfort foods.
The Griswold Sandwich. Buffalo fried chicken topped with bacon, syrup, and the Oats deep-fried poutine puck, all smothered in gravy and stuffed between 2 Belgian Liege waffles. And I've got to meet the maker, Chef Jonathan Shevlin.
So the Griswold came from one of the original waffle iron companies here in North America to advertise chicken and waffles.
So you guys took some history and a sandwich and kind of threw it all together here at the Oath.
Want to make the Griswold?
Well,
show me how to make it?
Jonathan sets the locally baked Liege waffles to warm while he prepares the Oats play on poutine.
So in Canada, poutine is a traditional dish in Montreal, and it's cheese, and it's fries, and it's gravy. But this is gonna be on a sandwich, so we need to keep it all kind of together, right?
Absolutely. So first off, I start out with a slab of extra sharp white cheddar. I dredge the cheese and flour, a little bit of egg wash. From here, we go right into our hash brown Parmesan panko breadcrumb mix.
Cool.
And from here, we drop it directly into the deep fryer.
Into the deep fryer.
While that cooks, we get started on the fried chicken. First, Jonathan coats the chicken in the Oats' own buffalo beer sauce.
My idea behind this was to make buffalo chicken without making a mess on your fingers.
Not so messy fried chicken. I like it.
I'm gonna add a secret ingredient.
It may resemble mustard, but I don't think it is. What is it?
It's French's yellow mustard.
It's French's yellow mustard.
I've never told anyone this recipe, and I now just told the world this recipe.
You're welcome, America.
Once coated in the wet marinade, the chicken is dredged in seasoned flour and dropped in the fryer. And when the crust is a deep golden brown, we're ready to assemble the sandwich.
We're gonna start off with 1 Belgian waffle, a piece of fried chicken, and then we're gonna top it with 3 slices of bacon.
3 slices of bacon, not too crispy, because we don't want it to shatter.
This is my sriracha maple syrup.
We're always chasing salty, we're always chasing sweet, and you're adding heat, I'm in love.
From there, we're gonna take our poutine puck. I'm gonna take brown gravy, and I'm gonna add it on top of my poutine puck.
Wow, and now we're putting on the last waffle. Man, that's a monster. Look at the size of this thing. Layers of chicken, poutine, bacon, waffle. Look at that, look at the cheese and the poutine just oozing out of the top of that. It's like almost the size of my face, which is remarkable because, let's face it, I have a huge face. All right, now it's time to dig in. I get sweetness of the waffle, I get the gravy, and now I just got smashed with some fried chicken. Wow, I've tasted all these flavors before, but not all at once. And you've done that here. You put all these elements into one sandwich. Phenomenal. Just outside Sleepy Hollow at Dobbs Dawg House, home of over 50 out-of-the-bun hot dog creations and the Dawg House Challenge. Since 2012, Dobbs Dawg House has hosted a challenge so huge, only three brave men have been victorious. A column on the menu, picked at random, will determine 12 fully loaded hot dogs. If I can finish them in 30 minutes or less, I'll earn a t-shirt and my place in their wall of fame. Time for my lunch date with Lady Luck. Will it be the classic column one, the tried and trusted column two, or the devastating column three? All right, Rob, fate has chosen column one. My fate sealed. We're about to get down and dirty with these dogs. The old school dog, the s'more dog, the border dog, the barbecue dog, the so yummy dog, the Mac attack, the jalapeno popper dog, the Greek salad dog, the rockin' rune, the rubble rage, the hot toddy, and the fried egg top sayonara dog.
So Casey, you have 30 minutes to eat 12 hot dogs. I'm gonna start you off with the old school.
Bring on the old school.
So timer's gonna start as soon as you put the dog in your mouth. So whenever you're ready.
Let the dogs out!
To start, I'm following Rob's advice. I need to get through the first five dogs as fast as I can. No time to savor them. But man, this old school's good. I only have 30 minutes to tackle these 12 dogs, so I gotta keep quiet and gotta start eating.
Four, you got the barbecue dog.
The barbecue!
He's going good, he's got this. He'll hit about seven and it'll start getting really rough. But he's going good pace, he's got to remember not to be overwhelmed by the dogs. He's got it.
Everybody quiet, Casey. You have 24 minutes left and you're already on your fifth dog. You're at an excellent pace. Keep it up, buddy.
So far, so good, but I'm starting to feel the burn.
Dog number six is the Mac attack. It's the hardest one of all.
Just made it to the Mac attack. I'm at the wall, but I gotta go over. I crest the cheese wall, and it's time to pick up the pace.
Guys, he's got 15 minutes left and five dogs to go. Let's keep it up, Casey. Come on, baby.
Come on, Casey. Keep going. Dog number nine, the Rockin' Rune. Dogs are so delicious. There's just so many.
5 minutes left and three dogs left, Casey. Come on, you got it. Power through it, baby. Power through it, baby.
The rubble rage slows me down. Between the dryness of the cereal and the spiciness of the chili sauce, I'm taking on water, which is filling me up. It takes me almost 3 minutes to put the rage down, which leaves me only two to go for the final two dogs.
Dog number 11, this is the hot toddy. You got two more to go, Casey. Let's go. Brother, you got this.
I still have a shot, but as I put away the hot toddy, I hear the countdown.
All right, guys, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh. Casey, I'm sorry, but your time is up.
I want to do the last dog.
Last dog?
I came this far, I want to finish the Dawg House Challenge.
I
finish, but not in time. No t-shirt, no wall of fame, but also no more hot dogs.